Hi, and thank you for joining me today. This is your friendly neighborhood librarian, and today we are going to be going over keywords and search strategy for your literature review for your senior project. So, the very first thing you want to think about when looking at your project is, how are you going to define your project? This might be the title you give it for your paper, for your poster session, and it's a short sentence that you're going to use. So some examples might be Mars drill design and automation, solar panel integration on hybrid school buses, enhanced video recording and display in operating rooms, or maybe design of an intelligent shelving system. This is a very short sentence that packs a lot of information to it. After you've come up with that description of your project, that short sentence, you then need to consider keywords. And this is typically where students are running into the most problems. There's a lot of reasons for that. Sometimes people don't know where to start. Other times, the way you're describing your topic may not be the way experts are writing about it. Now, you want to think about 2 to 3 keywords that can describe your topic off of that short sentence that you've created. And then after you have those keywords, you want to try and create as many synonyms for each concept and word as you can, and then narrow down what you have to what makes sense, because sometimes a synonym for a word might not be good in the actual search you do. All right, and you can use a thesaurus or subject terms from articles to find synonyms. You don't necessarily need to just come up with them on your own. Okay, and a good way to find expert terminology is to look through previous class books, papers, presentations you've had from your professors. Even talking with your professor sometimes can help you to figure out the right words you should be using. Let's take a look at a sample topic. I love examples. One of my favorite ones is a design for a lightweight mobile regolith excavation robotic platform. It looks like this. And if anybody notices the NASA logo, this is actually the NASA Racer. It's one of my favorite robots to take a look at. So we're going to start working on our keywords. The first thing I might pull is lightweight. Maybe I'm trying to focus on making a much lighter robot so it's easier for transport. And then regolith is kind of a key part of this robot, right? That's the layer that we're looking to collect samples from. And fundamentally, it needs to excavate. Used for sample collection. If we can't do that, we're gonna have some issues. Okay, so we're gonna pull out those keywords. We have our lightweight, our regolith, and excavation. And then now we need to take a look at the goals of our project. We have our keywords, but it's more than just our topic sentence. What does our project need to actually do? And if you look at those goals, you can get a better idea of what you should be searching for. So if I'm really trying to zero in on reducing that weight, I may want to make that an aspect of my search. Maybe I wanted to focus on increasing the volume of soil held instead. That's going to produce very different research from reducing weight. Or maybe you're working on something that has a conveyor system, right? If you want to improve that conveyor system for transportation, that's an important goal to consider. You can also look at the actual materials that are being used for your project if that's a key component. If some of those materials are interchangeable, you may not give it as much consideration. Or if it's just a baseline that you'll only use one type, this may not be the best. But if these components are integral to it and you are doing something different, then you can use those in keywords as well. And these can be as simple as aluminum, hydrogels, photovoltaic cells, if you are considering solar energy, titanium. Okay, and after we've come up with our list of potential keywords, we're gonna check out those synonyms, as I mentioned earlier. So excavation was one of the keywords that I pulled out. If I just consider excavation, some other synonyms for what I'm working with there might be mining, dig, burrow, boring. And not all of these words, when used in a search, are going to produce tangible results. So you need to look, use your judgment, and if you only find yourself getting 5 results, 1 result, 0 results, you may want to get rid of that word that you're using and replace it with something else. Another thing to consider is we don't just look at individual words, we also look at concepts. So The concept that I pulled out of my topic sentence was lightweight regolith excavation. Well, I could also look at lightweight foldable robot. That's one of the key features of the racer. It can fold so it doesn't get stuck. It can easily escape, which is good because it's on Mars and there isn't a person that can go help if it does get stuck. Another thing I could consider is robotic excavation. Maybe I'm more focused on that. I don't really care about the weight. The weight's unimportant to me. I could also look at a wheeled robot that operates in reduced gravity, or I could look at regolith structure. Maybe I'm somewhat unfamiliar with that concept and I need to find some more articles about that. You have a lot of ways of going at this and a lot of different concepts you could potentially look at. Now, after you have found some keywords, pulled the ones from your topic, just go ahead and start searching with them. I would try different databases, try our homepage search. There are other videos that go over different databases that could be useful. I would recommend checking out if you are unfamiliar with the library's resources. Change your individual words or concept if you're not getting results, as I mentioned earlier, and mix and match what you're working with until you get what you need. Look at multiple sources. Never just use one thing. We have different journals, different experts showing up in different resources that we have. And I would also recommend using Boolean operators. This would be not, or, and. And you'll see that in a later video, and I'll review those in more depth. If you do have any questions so far, please feel free to contact the library, and we would love to help you out. Good luck coming up with those keywords.